Okay, you're going to learn how to use ATR to, you know, evaluate option premiums and even the strike prices. That is, are you paying the right premium, and whether the price that you are expecting, will it be achieved? You know, I mean, see, many people buy options on the basis of emotions without calculating the price, whether there's a possibility of the price hitting that number which they expect it to hit. So this will teach you how to plan your options very rationally. Okay, now let's take an example. Let's say, okay, Reliance. Let's say that you are bullish and that you feel that it will cross 1600 rupees in January 2020, right? The expiry end of the month. Today's price on 9/1/20 is 1548. Okay, now you want to make money by buying the 1580 CE for Jan expiry, but you are unsure. Though you are bullish, you are unsure if the price will go to that extent and whether the premium that you are paying is the right premium. So the first thing is that you will check the premium. The 1580 call premium is 25 rupees 45 paise. Okay, for Jan expiry, 30th Jan, and the IV is 24.7. That's the implied volatility. I had already put up a video on implied volatility. If you have not viewed it, I suggest you view it, and I'm putting the link up, yeah, on the top of this video. So let's evaluate. Right, so 1580 C for Jan expiry, premium is 2545, CMP is 1548, IV is 24.7. Okay, so is the premium overpriced? So the CMP is 1548, the strike price is 1580, the intrinsic value is 32, 1580 minus 1548, 32. Plus you are paying a premium of 25.45. Okay, now from tomorrow onwards we have about 20 days to expiry, and our assumption is that Reliance will cross 1580 at least 4 to 5 days before expiry. There are weekends in between, so that we can make a decent return. You know, if it goes to 1580 by expiry, you will not get anything, you lose everything, you lose your premium. Okay, so we wanted to hit 1580 in advance. Okay, based on that, we have to guesstimate whether we are paying the right premium and whether the OTM is the right OTM to buy, right? So if you take out weekends, we have net 15 days before this happens. Okay, we need to check the possibility of this happening, and this is where ATR can help us. So let's go to the ATR. Okay, before we go to the ATR, let's first check the implied volatility and what is the implication of implied volatility. Okay, implied volatility of 24.7%, it suggests that Reliance will fluctuate 24.7% into 1548 in 1 year, which is around 382 bucks. Roughly 32 per month. See, 32 per month is not a hard and fast rule. It can go to 64, it can go to 90 per month, and the next month it can come down. That's what implied volatility suggests. It's not a hard and fast rule, you know. Okay, so let us say, as a, you know, basic simple rule of thumb, that the implied volatility is suggesting that it will fluctuate 32 per month. Okay, so since we have got 20 days to expiry, okay, if we go with this calculation, with 32 rupees being the maximum fluctuation, then we should not buy, 1580 is strike price, because the implied volatility suggests a 32 rupees jump up, right? So if 32 is always going to jump up, that means as per implied volatility, it'll close at something like 1580. It might 1580 or something like that. It's already gone up 48 bucks this month. I'm going to show you the charts. And so there's really no point buying. But now here's where we need to check the ATR. Okay, let's now go to the ATR. This is the CMP is 1548. Strike price is 1580. Intrinsic value 32 bucks. Premium you're paying 25 bucks. Now look at the ATR here. This is the ATR. Okay, the ATR is 131. I explained to you yesterday in yesterday's video that the ATR gives you the range. I'm using the monthly charts over here. Okay, here this is 1 month, and the Reliance fluctuation is 131.8 something, say 132. So it can either move up by 132, move down by 132 in the period of 1 month. In this month, it's already up around 48 bucks, right? And the volatility is very high. Okay, so this is the data that ATR is giving us. The implied volatility is telling us that it will fluctuate 32 bucks. But the ATR is telling us that it can fluctuate. It has the range is 132 bucks. And there's still a lot, many number of days to go, you know. So what should we conclude, you know? See, the volatility is very high as per ATR. You've seen it, you know, it's very high over here. This is low volatility, around 45, 40, 46 rupees range per month for Reliance is low volatility. And 132 is definitely very high. This was 70, this is 114. I've just marked it over here, okay? So volatility is very high. Therefore, option premium will be overpriced. Option premium is overpriced. We just checked that, you know, we applied the IV and checked it is overpriced. So as per IV, the 1580 is not a buy. However, ATR suggests it can fluctuate from now. It's already fluctuated 48 bucks. It can fluctuate another 70 to 130 bucks up or down, huh? During the month. Therefore, if you are confident of your bullishness, if you are, say, around, your confidence should be 70 to 80%, whoever is advising you or whatever you are analyzing, you should be confident. If you are not confident, if it's a hit or a miss, then don't use this calculation, don't use this theory, okay? So if you are, say, 80% confident that Reliance will go up this month, you can buy, because it has the potential to fluctuate 132, and see, you're betting on a fluctuation of 32 bucks over here. Intrinsic value, right? 1548 to 1580. If it goes to 1580, your premium starts appreciating, so long it happens four, five days before expiry. Okay, so we are looking at 132 bucks is the ATR. So the ATR is telling you, yes, you can go ahead and buy. Okay, however, since the premium is overpriced, we just understood that, what you can do is you can buy 1580 CE at 25 rupees 45 paise, and you can sell 1620 CE at 1320. I'll just show this to you in a hurry. 1 second here. This is 13 rupees 20 paise, 1620. So even with ATR of 132, it may go to 1620 and stop there. So you may even collect that premium and make the gains on this one. Okay, so this is a safer bet. Instead of going in for a naked option play, this is a safer bet. Your net cost will be 12 rupees 25 paise. Your investment would be, you know, 525, that's 12,500 rupees or something like that, plus 65 or 70,000 rupees you'll have to pay for the option that you're selling. So for 87,000, your bullishness is covered. You have 500 shares of Reliance. This is per lot I'm talking about. And I mean, it's a pretty safe trade so long you are confident of your bullishness. Now, when Reliance touches 1590, you should sell both. Sell your CE and sell your sell both your CEs, 1580, 1620. So this is how you use ATR to calculate your options, to strategize your options. You know, whatever you're buying or selling, you know, you check the ranges, check your implied volatility, check your premiums, see whether what you're paying is reasonable or not. Okay, for example, if the range of Reliance was also 32, as in the case of intrinsic value, or of the implied volatility, you wouldn't touch it, you know, then it's a no buy. So you can do your own calculations that way. I'll stop for now and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye. Thanks.